Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's your girl Lungu, back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. Today I'm going to be reacting to It Is So Easy to Refute Them. To that, so without wasting time, let's get into the video.
Now the Christians have developed new techniques. They come to you, they come to your house. They said, you believe in Jesus? You said, yes, we believe in Jesus. No Muslim is a Muslim if he does not believe in Jesus. He says, you know, Jesus was one of the mightiest messengers of God. You accept that? He said, of course we accept that. He was one of the mightiest messengers of God. He is a major prophet. He's a Rasul. We accept that. He says, you know, Jesus, he was born miraculously without any male intervention. You believe in that? He said, yes, yes, we believe in that. Everything you got to agree. Look, his plan, he's making you say, yes, yes, yes. You believe that he was born miraculously? You said, yes. Was your Muhammad born like that? He says, no. He had a father and a mother. He said, yes. That's all. He's got a point. That Jesus is a degree above Muhammad. He didn't say that, but he proved it to you. He says, you know, Jesus is Masihullah. He's the Messiah, translated Christ. You accept that? Yes, yes, we accept that. Your Prophet Muhammad, was he Masihullah? Was he Allah's Messiah? He said, no, he's Rasulullah. But you see, Isa is Rasul and Masih in the Quran. Rasul and Ila Bani Israel, Masihu is Ibn Maryam in your Quran. He is Masih and Rasul. Your Prophet is only Rasul. He said, that is so. Jesus is another degree above Muhammad. He is just proving it to you. He doesn't even tell you that. He's proved it to you. He said, you know, Jesus, he gave life back to the dead. He said, yes, yes, biiznillah. Mm-hmm. He said, did Muhammad give life back to the dead, biiznillah? I say, I don't know. I have no knowledge. Jesus is another degree above Muhammad. He's proving it to you. He said, where is Jesus? He says, he's in heaven. He's coming back. He said, yes. Where is your Prophet Muhammad? You see, he's buried in Medina. Perhaps his bones have rotted in the grave. You say, no, he's Hayatun Nabi. He's the living prophet. That's metaphysically, man, spiritually. But physically, maybe his bones have rotted in the grave. You say, maybe. Jesus is another degree above Muhammad. So don't you think God had a purpose in doing all that? He does things for nothing. In a few weeks' time, you're going to make Eid al-Adha, Qurbani. You're going to sacrifice a sheep or a goat or a cow. Without blemish, no fault, ear not cut, horn not broken, not blind, not limping, right? You look for a perfect animal. If God Almighty wants to make a sacrifice for His creation, is He going to look for second best? When you look for the best animal for your Qurbani, Allah going to look for second best? You say, no. He's proved it to you, He's second best. Come on, come on, come on, talk now, talk. Talk, man, talk. No, this is not your field. You see, we didn't delve into that. Wallah, this is the simplest things to answer all. I have written a book called Christ in Islam that answers all that. But briefly. The guy said Jesus was born without a father. I said, right, true. He was born miraculously. Muhammad was born like you and me. Accepted. So therefore, he's superior to Muhammad. Is that what you're trying to say? I said, yes. Muhammad had a father and mother. Jesus had only a mother. That makes him superior. So, if that's your logic, then the one who's got no father and no mother, Jesus had a mother. Right? You said, yes. But if the guy who got no father and no mother is superior to Jesus. He says, no, that's correct. Who can that be? So Allah tells in the Quran, Inna masala Isa, inna Allahi ka masali Adama. The similitude or the example of Jesus in the sight of Allah is like that of Adam. Khalaqahu min turabin. Allah created him from dust. Thumma qala lahu kun fayakun. And he said, be, and he was. So Adam is a greater God. He's got no father and no mother. Stand to reason. Your logic. You said Jesus is superior to Muhammad because Muhammad had a father and mother and Jesus had only a mother. I said, right? Adam had no father and no mother. He's superior to Jesus. Are you prepared to accept him as your God? No. Why? What's wrong? Then there is another fellow in your Bible. In your Bible, in the book of Hebrews, there are 66 books here. One of them is called the book of Hebrews, chapter 7, verse 1. It speaks about Melchizedek. Melchizedek, Melek, Sadek, Sadek, Sade, Sade. Melchizedek, the high priest of Salem, Salam, Jerusalem. Without father, I'm reading. Chapter 7, verse 1. Without father, without mother, without beginning, without end. Who can that be? These are the qualities of God. He is the only one who's got no beginning, no end, who's got no father and no mother. This man, Melchizedek, has got that. So he is greater than Jesus, greater than Adam. Are you prepared to worship him? Your book, your Bible. So in the ayah I quoted you, Allah says, whenever they make any claim, ask him, Kul hatu burhanakum. Produce your proof. And he has produced it, the Bible. Anything, so my Bible says this, my Bible says that, my Bible says this. You must now learn to examine his book. How do you do that? I don't want to start from one end to the other. Encyclopedia, 66 books. You got time for that? No. You get my little booklets. And there's a body of society who are prepared to publish them. I'm prepared to help them. If the community can't help these people to produce these booklets, what the Bible says about Muhammad. Muhammad, the natural successor to Christ. Christ in Islam. I'm prepared to help you. There's a little booklet, 12-page little booklet. Called What Was the Sign of Jonah? 12 pages. Little booklet like this, 12 pages. You master that, there isn't a Christian born who can stand before you. But you got to do a little bit of homework. You can't swallow a pill and become a Superman, black belt karate expert. You got to exercise, my sons. You know that? I don't know whether you know anything about karate. You know? I know karate, I know boxing. You know? I'm telling you. So I know I have to sweat, man, sweat. You know, exercise, weight, pumping up weight and doing all kinds of things. Therefore, you see, I'm 75 years old, I'm still standing straight before you guys. No, you got to sweat. Similarly, that little booklet. You master that and there isn't a Christian born who can stand before you. But you got to do that homework. You got to read the book, learn the verses, and then go to town. The customers. Yes, there's an ocean of customers here. Yeah, the whole of Kenya. At the beginning of the century, Africa was 3% Christian. Today, 40% of Africa is Christian. 40%. And by the turn of this century, they want to make Africa a Christian continent. And there are every signs that they'll succeed. If we're going to sleep like this, the way we are sleeping, they will succeed. You are sitting back on our backside, say, so we'll go to heaven. Just like that. We made salat, we give zakat, heaven. It's not that cheap. Wallah, it's not that cheap. You have to sweat for it. However, says Melchizedek, high priest of Salem. Are you prepared to worship him? In your book, your Bible. How to burhanakum, his burhan. No. He's Masih. Muhammad is only Rasul. I said, look, every prophet is Masih. What is Masih? Masih means appointed. Officially anointed. Anointed means priests and kings were in, officially when you brought to the position, they used to anoint them with holy oil. Or with water. Say, from today you are our priest. From today you are our king. That's all. Every prophet of God is anointed. But we don't use the title. We don't use the title for everybody. We especially use for Jesus. He is Masihullah. Who is Kalimullah? Who is Kalimullah?
Musa.
Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. That means Allah spoke to him. Didn't he not speak to Jesus? He spoke to him. Did he not speak to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He spoke to him. But why we say Jesus, Musa Kalimullah? No. That's a title we give him. But all the prophets were speaking to Allah. See? Rasulullah. When we say Rasul, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Correct. But was Isa not Rasulullah? Is not Musa Rasulullah? So the Quran says so. Musa is Rasul. Ibrahim is Rasul. Isa is Rasul. But when we say Rasulullah, in our mind, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Can you see now? It's a title you specially use for someone. You say, Alfred the Great in England. You read British history, Alfred the Great. The guy who burned the cake. Is that what he's making great? Richard the Lionhearted. You heard the name? Richard the Lionhearted. British history. Richard the Lionhearted. I say every other British king was a chicken-hearted fellow. No. Why you call this guy Lionhearted? It's just a title you give this. That Alfred the Great. Oh, what are you, other great men? Yeah, you just Akbar the Great, the bloody rubbish in India. You know, he tried to create a religion between Hinduism and Islam mixture. The bastardization of Islam and Hinduism. And we call him Akbar the Great. This is how you just give titles to people. Masih. Every prophet is Masih, is appointed, is anointed by Allah, but specially we give it to Jesus. And so on. It is so easy, wallah, it is so easy if you do a little bit of homework.
That was interesting to watch. Comparing. It's like comparing ourselves to the next person that's next to us. Why do you have to compare? Should I think I'm better than you? Or should you think you're better than me because of one or two features or something? I don't think that's okay. And just doesn't make sense that even after all these years, the two are quite, we have to compare the two to each other. At the end of the day, I think it all comes down to the fact that we're all human. They were human as well. So why should one human be greater than another? It doesn't make sense to me. You just end up confusing yourself. You just end up upsetting yourself. You just end up conflicting with people because you think you have all the points in the world to prove that this person was better than the rest, which shouldn't be the case. We're all equal in the eyes of God, I'd love to believe. Let me know what you guys actually think about what was said in this video. If there's something you want me to react to, drop the link in the comment section below and I'll be more than glad to react to it. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.